Use technology to graph the following functions and then complete both sentences for each function. A, as x approaches positive infinity, y approaches blank. And B, as x approaches negative infinity, y approaches blank. So let's go ahead and start with y1 is equal to x cubed. On your calculator, go to y equals, and for y1, enter x raised to the third power. And then let's start by creating a standard viewing window. We'll go to zoom and select zoom standard, which is number 6. Zoom standard goes from negative 10 to 10 along the horizontal axis and from negative 10 to 10 along the vertical axis. So first of all, we want to determine what happens as x goes to positive infinity. In other words, we want to determine the right end behavior. As x goes out to the right, what happens to the y values? Well, as we trace along the function, we can see that the y values are getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and they're increasing without boundary. So we would say that y is going to infinity. Or in words, as x approaches positive infinity, y approaches positive infinity as well. In part B, it says as x goes to negative infinity, y goes to blank. Well, as x goes to negative infinity, we're investigating the left end behavior of the function. As we move to the left, what happens to the y values? Well, we trace the function moving to the left, and we see that the function goes down and that it's decreasing without boundary. That means that the y values are approaching negative infinity. So as x goes to negative infinity, y goes to negative infinity as well. And our next function is y2 is equal to x squared. So we'll go back to y equals. We can turn off y1, go on top of y equals and press enter, and then move down to y2 and enter x raised to the second power, or x squared. Okay, sketch a graph. And then go through the same reasoning process. First of all, we want to determine the right end behavior. As x increases without boundary, what happens to the y values? Well, we see that as we move to the right, we're also moving up, and we're moving up without any boundary. So that means that the y values are approaching positive infinity. So as x goes to infinity, y goes to positive infinity. For part B, we're investigating the left end behavior. As x goes to minus infinity, what's happening to the y values? Well, as we trace along the function moving to the left, we see that we're also going up and that we're increasing without boundary. That means that the y values are approaching positive infinity. So as x goes to minus infinity, y goes to positive infinity. We go back to y equals, and we'll turn off y2. So use your arrow key to move on top of the equal, press enter to turn y2 off, and then move down to y3 and enter 1 divided by, now be careful here, we want to divide by the quantity x plus 3. So you'll need to use a left parenthesis and then x plus 3. And then a right parenthesis. So y equals 1 divided by the quantity x plus 3. Go ahead and sketch the graph. And go through the same reasoning process. First of all, what happens is x increases without boundary. What is the right end behavior of the function? Well, as we move along the function, we see that the y values are decreasing as we move to the right, but they're not decreasing without boundary. There is a boundary, and that boundary seems to be the x-axis, and the y values along the x-axis are 0. So in this case, as x increases without boundary, or as x approaches positive infinity, the y values are approaching 0. So as x goes to infinity, y goes to 0. What happens as x goes to minus infinity? Well, as x goes to minus infinity, we trace along the function, we see that the y values are increasing, but they're not increasing without a boundary, they're increasing with a boundary, and that boundary, once again, is the x-axis. And the y values along the x-axis are 0, so as x goes to minus infinity, y goes to 0. And one of the features that we notice on this graph is that the graph has a horizontal asymptote at y is equal to 0. So when our graph has a horizontal asymptote like this, the end behavior is 0. What about for y4? 1 over x plus 2. Go back to y equals, turn off y3. And then for y4, enter 1 divided by x plus 2. And notice that this time we did not use parentheses. We want to divide 1 by x and then add 2 to the result. So no parentheses are needed. Go ahead and sketch the graph. As x goes to positive infinity, we notice that the function is decreasing, but it's decreasing with a boundary. This time the boundary is not the x-axis. The boundary is above the x-axis. It looks like the y-values are about 2 there, but in order to get a better feeling for this, we might create a table of values. Let's go to second window, which is table set, and move down to the independent variable and change it to ask mode. Once you've put your calculator into ask mode, then go to the table, which is second graph, and we want to investigate what happens as x approaches positive infinity. So let's type in some different x values. Let's start off with 10. And then x is increasing without boundary, or x is approaching positive infinity. So x is getting bigger and bigger. So I'll enter 100 and then 1,000. And 10,000. And what we can see is that as x increases without boundary, as x approaches positive infinity, the y values are decreasing, but they seem to have a boundary, and that boundary appears to be the number 2. The values are getting closer and closer to the number 2. So as x goes to infinity, y approaches 2. What happens as x approaches negative infinity? Let's look back at our graph. As we move off to the left, we see that the y values are increasing as we move to the left, but they're increasing with a boundary, and once again that boundary appears to be 2. So as x increases, or as x decreases without boundary, as x approaches negative infinity, y approaches positive 2 once again. And just to reinforce that, let's go back to our table. And this time, let's change the x values from positive to negative. What happens when x is negative 10? And then negative 100. Negative 1,000. Negative 10,000. Well, this time we see that the y values are increasing, but they're increasing with a boundary, and that boundary appears to be the number 2. And so as x goes to minus infinity, or as x approaches negative infinity, the y values approach 2.